Technology has changed the way the Chamber of Commerce engages members. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Local Edition. With me this hour is Ellen Horan. She is President and CEO of the Greater Reading Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me, Jill.
When we talk about technology and we talk about the way you engage members, you say world events, particularly world economic events, are helping you to interact in a different way with your members.
Definitely. That was one of the neat things that happened with the past presidential election. Obama's charisma, I think, engaged a lot more people in the political process, but he also utilized social media and different electronic technologies that got people interested in being involved in different ways in communicating in the public policy arena.
And in turn, your chamber has taken that as a first step, as a catalyst, really, to change the way you're interacting with your members.
Right. I kind of think of it as we've been able to take it up a notch. We've always been involved as a chamber in the public policy arena, but it was usually holding breakfasts or encouraging members, could you please write letters on different issues, whereas now we're able to be much more timely, and we've created an electronic venue that members can utilize to contact their legislators at the push of a button.
So by going to your website, which is greaterreadingchamber.org, we can find a link really to have access to all of that public policy information and to our legislators.
And to the legislators at the federal, state, and local levels. Issues right now that are real hot with the members are, of course, the economic stimulus package, the taxes that are in Obama's new budget are of extreme concern. There's also an issue called card check that is of great importance to business, and also 222 North. We're trying to lobby in support of that.
So when we talk about issues impacting your members, we're talking about things that are happening at a more local level, like road construction,
right?
But also things that are happening at a national or even global level when we talk about an economic bailout. How do you take all of these issues and make them work and move public policy forward
right,
so that it impacts your membership?
One, you have to have an easy way for people to understand what the issues are. And people are used to going to the internet to get information. So they like going into one place and having it summarized for them. We also make it really easy with the sub-website of the Greater Reading Chamber site called Greater Reading Voice, where if they put their address in, they can then be told who their congressmen are, who their state representatives are, who their senators are. And there's also then sample letters they can send. They can modify them, they can write their own letters, they can send a canned letter that's there. And we do it on the different topics that they're telling us are important to them. So it's kind of a one-stop shop.
Now that this website has been live, what kind of response are you getting from your membership in terms of their increased involvement in the public policy arena?
Well, right now, overwhelmingly, businesses focus on the card check issue. Mm-hmm. The card check issue is where a union could run a campaign simply by getting employees to sign a card. There is no private election then. And they feel that's undermining a fundamental constitutional right in this country. It's a secret ballot. Our elected officials are elected in a secret ballot. When you go to vote in an election, you go behind a curtain and you vote in private. You vote your conscience. With the card check issue, employees would not have that right to a secret ballot. So overwhelmingly, we've had over 600 messages sent in just the 3 weeks that the site is up on the card check issue alone.
And that's interesting that you bring that up, because that has been a very controversial issue in terms of the union opinion and business opinion,
right,
and the government's perspective as well. But it's an idea where you can move the agenda of your membership forward
right,
through technology.
Right, absolutely, absolutely. The second most frequently used issue on the site is the 222 North. Talk about another hot button. Anybody that's had to travel up to 78 or Allentown, you know what 222 North is like, and PennDOT has held the funds on that.
Okay, well, a lot of issues at stake and a lot to find out on your website. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
We've been talking with Ellen Horan. I'm Jill Horner.